Have you heard of servanthood leadership? It's a great concept, isn't it? But I feel like it's a really boring title. I much prefer to call it managing the stoke of your business. What is the word stoke, you may ask? Well, in the Oxford Dictionary, being stoked means being excited or euphoric. It's the highest satisfaction feeling you can have. When our employees are stoked from achieving goals and they are aligned with the company's objectives, they make better decisions and lead teams more productively. I believe in people-first organizations. When the leadership of an organization focuses on their people's environment and performance behaviors first over profits, they actually earn better profits. You know, people grow businesses and people grow passion for the business from an epic culture in the organization. Passion plus the right action equals results. And we all want great results, don't we? And there's definitely no doubt that culture drives performance. Now, when an organization focuses too heavily on a family culture, it can produce weak leadership and employees that could have entitlement issues and are maybe possibly lazy. When an organization focuses too heavily on a high-performance culture, they sometimes produce burnout employees and could produce a leadership with no compassion. So, how do you create an epic culture in an organization? How do you become an employer of choice? Most importantly, how do you create an environment where all your employees love their job and are proud of the company they represent and deliver great results for the organization? Hi, my name is Theodore Vairaktaris. I'm an entrepreneur. I've come from very humble beginnings. My passion is growing people and growing businesses. Today, I'll give you 12 secret pillars that will ensure your people are stoked, and as a leader, you're ensuring you're creating an epic culture and a sustainable, scalable workplace environment that is a blend of a family culture and a high-performance team culture. Now, too much of either creates issues in any organization. Balance is definitely the key here. So, let's start with the 12 secret pillars we should all live by. Imagine if every leader around the world made hiring decisions on these pillars and assign these pillars to every month of the year, and then they could use it as a reminder to inspect the culture and their performance measures. Because what doesn't get inspected doesn't get respected. So today, I've created an example, and it could look something like this. January, gratitude and reflection. Even when things are not going great, but especially when things are going great, you must ensure you value your people and measure your people in your business. Gratitude and reflection. Be grateful for who you've attracted and reflect on their performance regularly and ensure you are setting their goals for the year ahead to help them grow. Or for new employees, ensure the expectation of the organization is clear to them. People need a measuring stick. They need to know that they're on the right track and what the future looks like for them. We need to invest in them and we need to nurture them so they can achieve those goals. This will only improve productivity and give them perspective. People grow businesses. Systems and processes just guide them. Gratitude and reflection. February. We should all know this one. The love month. Love thyself and love one another. It's all about how we treat one another. Ensure you're checking in with your team and they still love what they do. And are they being treated correctly? Do they still stand for what the company represents? It's all about love. Love is the greatest and most powerful influential emotion in the known universe. Love grows passion and accountability, which empowers people to make the right decisions for the right reasons for themselves, for their colleagues, and for the organization they represent. When your people embody this behavior, your customers will be drawn to them because people connect with passionate people. They also become a beacon of light and of hope in an organization's developing culture. Love. March. Happiness. Have you heard this term? Happy people help people. Hurting people always hurt people. Always remember that. Okay, let's say that again. Happy people help people. Hurting people hurt people. Happiness. When you create an environment for your people to be safe and happy, they join teams, they become inclusive, and they help one another when a fellow colleague may need it most. Typically, Happy people are successful in their roles. They set and achieve their goals. They grow and push themselves to find that satisfaction from success. Happiness in your workplace will ensure your organization is set for success. It's always fun being around happy people. Be happy. Happiness. April. Truth. We need to ensure we create an environment where our people feel safe to tell the truth without being judged. Truth. As leaders, we need to hear all the right or wrong things that are occurring. Because how do we make decisions without knowing the truth? No business makes any good decisions on half of the truth, or worse, on lies. Allowing the truth without judgment creates a safe working environment. It builds trust and it builds loyalty. Truth is a core pillar to a high-performance team culture because we also need our people to be able to hear the truth and not be defensive when we bring them feedback. Feedback propels performance, and we need less BS in this world and more truth. Truth. May, I personally love this one. Creativity. Ensure you allow your people to explore and push the boundaries on your systems and processes. Allow them to be creative. Creativity. We need collaboration and new ways of thinking in our world. We all have amazing young people coming up through the ranks. Let them be heard. Listen to their ideas. Let them challenge the status quo of your systems and processes. Encouraging creativity helps expand the mind, helps us rethink situations for a greater outcome. When was the last time you allowed your people to challenge your way? It actually happened to me recently. And I was questioned why I supported the person that went outside of the boundaries and didn't achieve the desired outcome. Well, I did this because they challenged the process, and they did this in a way that was more productive, which worked really well. Although we didn't get the entire desired end outcome, but they still got experience through being creative. As leaders, we need to ensure we support our people desiring to grow and achieving greater results for the organization. Creative thinkers are going to help us save the world. Creativity. June, awareness. Keep your people grounded. We need to ensure we keep them aware of the organization's objectives, the strategic plan, and goals short-term and long-term. Ensure they are fully aware of the environment your organization operates in. Ensure as a leader, you are casting the vision correctly of the objectives of the organization and of their role and the direction you are driving the ship. Awareness. You can't build a high-performance team when your people are not clear of the direction or the objective of the organization. Clarity and awareness gives them confidence that they are on the right track and they understand what is expected of them by the organization. Awareness. July. Forgiveness. Mistakes are a human trait. Why do we say we are only human? Because we make mistakes. Why do some leaders around the world hang people out to dry? Why? Forgiveness. We must learn to forgive on the small errors so people can learn through those experiences. Don't worry about the spilt milk. Consider it as an experience, not just a lesson learned. Experiences build resilience and professional experience. Now, I'm not saying forgive your employees for everything. We all know serious misconduct is unforgivable and must be dealt with professionally. However, encouraging your leadership to give where they can, to build compassion, trust, and loyalty, forgiveness can be a powerful tool to building an epic culture. Forgiveness. August. Accountability and countability. We all need this in our lives. There is a difference between accountability and countability. We need to own up and be accountable to ourselves and countable to others, to our families, to our colleagues, and to our organization. We grow respect and trust when we hold ourselves accountable and when we are countable to others. Can your colleagues and your organization count on you like your family can? Accountability and countability builds reliability and ownership in a team. Accountability and countability. September. Generosity. We need to reward our people even on little wins. We need to let them feel that emotion from completing a task successfully with a reward. generosity. Achievements need to be recognized. It builds job satisfaction and grows a desire to achieve greater results. Rewards can come in many ways. Be creative with it. I frequently use the feedback loop as a reward. We want our people to have a healthy relationship with high performance. Also, allow your people in your organization to be generous with customers, with their colleagues, and the community without expectation of something given back. This can come in many forms, not just physical generosity, also emotional support, and your time and your thoughts. Always remember this. People remember generous people. It builds strength in any relationship, it grows accountability, and it grows loyalty and passion. Generosity. October, kindness. Random acts of kindness are proven to help build confidence, trust in one another, and it builds a safe environment for our employees. Kindness. Kindness will always overcome a toxic environment and calms the mood of any troubled situation. Kindness has many forms: words of affirmation, edification, quality time, acts of service, and so on. Kindness creates a happy environment for your employees and the people that they work with outside of your organization. Encourage your employees to embody this behavior. It helps them grow respect and relationships. If you can be anything, be kind. Kindness. November, compassion. We need to listen to our employees. There is a reason we have two ears and one mouth. Listen to your employees more. Compassion. Process what they are going through so you can help them become a better version of themselves. Compassion bonds people together. Compassion builds reliability. Compassion builds accountability. Compassion helps our people know not just what we know, but how much we care. Compassion. December, the family month. If you have implemented the previous 11 secret pillars, congratulations. You have the fundamentals to build a family environment that focuses on a high performance result. Family. Family environments build communities. It builds accountable team members, and it is the core to growing amazing humans. Not just bloodline families, groups of people that interact as families. When your organization behaves like a family with a high-performance goal strategy, you've built an epic culture. Your people will be stoked. They will love their job. They will strive to be the best versions of themselves. They will grow your business, they will grow profits, and they will keep your customers loyal. But mostly, they will love their job, and they will love to work in your organization's epic environment and be proud to represent your organization. Family. There you go. You just learned the 12 secret pillars to building an epic culture. We need our leaders to create a culture of compassion, passion, and inclusivity. But we also need our leaders to ensure it is based around a high-performance culture, meeting the objectives of the organization. The key is to take the vibe and essence of a family culture, such as loyalty, inclusivity, and unconditional support, and blend it into a high-performance, enhancing the outcome of the organization. I'll leave you with this. Can I ask you honestly, are your employees happy? Are they proud to work for your organization? Ask yourself, how are you measuring the stoke in your organization? How are you ensuring you're building a high-performance culture that is focused on winning with family culture values? Lastly, are you proud of what you're doing to ensure you're building an epic culture? I hope so.